अस्सलाम वालेकुम रहमतुल्लाहि वबरकातुहू। बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया खालिद साहब आपका कि आपने अपने बिजी शेड्यूल में थोड़ा वक्त निकाला हमारे इस ग्रुप में। तो दरअसल एक ग्रुप हमने तैयार किया हुआ है जिसका नाम है रीच आउट जो फिजिक्स एंड मैथमेटिक्स। और इस ग्रुप का काम ये रहेगा कि ये हमारी कोशिश इसमें रहेगी कि हम सेकेंडरी लेवल तक या प्राइमरी और मिडल लेवल तक जितने भी स्कूल्स है उनमें जाके बच्चों में बेसिक जो फिजिक्स और मैथमेटिक्स है उनके बेसिक्स क्लियर करें उन्हें। क्योंकि जितना भी देखने में आ रहा है हमने अपने सब्जेक्ट्स को महदूद रखा है सवाल जवाब तक, क्वेश्चन आंसर तक, और उसके बाद हम आइडियाज़ को साइड में लगा देते हैं। तो हमारी इस ग्रुप में जो टीचर वॉलंटियर टीचर है वो स्कूल्स में जाके डिफरेंट स्कूल्स पे जाके बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट्स पे काम करेंगे ताकि जितने भी स्टूडेंट्स जो इंटरेस्टेड होंगे फिजिक्स को एज ए कैरियर लेने के लिए या मैथमेटिक्स को एज ए कैरियर लेने के लिए उनको प्रॉपरली डिलीवरेंस हो जाए, उनके प्रॉपरली हम उनको डिलीवर करेंगे एग्जैक्ट टाइम पे ताकि वो अपना आगे का मुस्तकबिल अच्छी तरह से संवार सकते हैं। तो जितना भी देखने में मिला है कि फिजिक्स या मैथमेटिक्स बहुत सारे कम बच्चे लेते हैं, जो मेरा यहाँ पे जो मैंने देखा हुआ है जो अपने इलाके का हाल है, एक हायर सेकेंडरी में सिर्फ 11% मैथमेटिक्स बच्चों ने लिया है, दूसरे में सिर्फ 7% बच्चों ने मैथमेटिक्स लिया है और दिन ब दिन इसका रोल घटता जा रहा है। क्या वजह हो सकती है, क्या फोबिया है? तो इस ग्रुप का यही काम है कि हम बेसिक रीज़न देखेंगे कि क्या हमारे डिलीवरेंस में प्रॉब्लम है, क्या हमारे सिस्टम में कुछ प्रॉब्लम है या टीचिंग लर्निंग जो मेथड्स है उसमें प्रॉब्लम है कि जिसकी वजह से मैथमेटिक्स दिन ब दिन डिटेरेट हो रहा है और फिजिक्स में इंटरेस्ट कम हो रही है। तो यही हमारी कोशिश होगी, इसीलिए हमने आज इस प्लेटफॉर्म पे डॉक्टर खालिद सुल्तान को इनवाइट किया हुआ है।
कंटिन्यू एंड द वे यू इंट्रोड्यूस्ड योर ग्रुप दैट यू आर आई मीन गोइंग टू नो द रीजन बिहाइंड द डिक्लाइन इन द परसेंटेज ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स फॉर एस्पायरिंग फॉर द मैथ्स एंड फिजिक्स। आई गेस द मैथ्स और फिजिक्स दे आर मच रिलेटेड टू ईच अदर। यू नो मैथ्स इज essential tool for the physics and physics is a rich source for inspiration for the mathematics and we cannot ignore the contribution of mathematics in the society. The Roger I guess I am reminded of the fact that there was a scientist, a philosopher, Roger Bacon, in the 13th century he once told that one who is ignorant in mathematics he can never have any information about other sciences as well. So that just gives us the insight of the importance of mathematics in our lives. So mathematics and physics are interrelated to each other. And as for your introduction of the topic that we need to know the reason why the students don't opt for the mathematics or physics in general as their career option or even at the higher secondary level, I guess there can be a couple of reasons for that. The first reason is, I guess if we talk about science in general, not about only the physics, we know currently at least there is a trend among the students that students seem to be highly attracted towards technology, but they don't seem to be attracted behind the science behind that technology. Suppose every student will be interested in mobile, but they won't be interested to know the science about this mobile, the science about this technology. So one reason I personally find is that apart from students, because students, this is a national inheritance, now the students are attracted towards the technology, but we as the teachers need to get them interested in the science behind that technology. That's one. Second, where I think the mathematics and the science, where the students are lacking, even as you rightly pointed out, you gave some percentage statistical interpretation regarding the students opting science from your area as well. Even on a broader perspective, it's not a local problem, it's a universal problem, I should say. Only 9% of the students globally seem to be attracted or loving the subject of the mathematics, while around 88% seem to hate the mathematics. So it's a universal problem. It's not about our local. It's not a local issue. So the first problem, where I stated that students seem to love science, technology, but don't seem to love the science behind that technology. Second, what I feel is we need students regarding the mathematics. Students feel it abstract. Students don't seem to be involved in number. This just all seems to be abstract for them, unlike suppose, some other stuff like history. They seem to relate physically to that history. Suppose we're talking about some historian, that this thing happened, that thing happened. So this, they seem to physically relate with them. But as far as mathematics is concerned, it totally seems abstract to them. They don't seem to physically relate to that. One. Second, as far as mathematics is concerned, mathematics would need more time to grasp the similar stuff. But what we do as a, at a school level or at the secondary level, we need to give equal time and equal importance to all the subjects. So I don't mean to be unfair to other subjects or demean the importance of other subjects, but mathematics is a kind of subject which would need more time to grasp for the students.
जी, तो यहाँ से मैं एक पॉइंट ऐड करना चाहूँगा कि डॉक्टर साहब कि हम जब फिजिक्स पढ़ाते होते हैं, हम डेमोन्स्ट्रेट करते होते हैं, हम एक्सपेरिमेंट नहीं करते होते असल में, क्योंकि डेमोन्स्ट्रेशन के दौरान तो हम कैलकुलेशन का कोई मैकेनिज्म रखते ही नहीं है. तो एक्सपेरिमेंट के टाइम पे हमें तो कैलकुलेशन करनी ही पड़ती है, जिसमें मैथ्स भी इन्वॉल्व हो जाता है. दैट इज़ वन ऑफ द रीज़न आई हैव फेल्ट इन आवर टीचिंग लर्निंग सिस्टम. तो अब मेरा क्वेश्चन है कुछ दूसरा डॉक्टर साहब कि हम कैसे इन बच्चों में फिजिक्स और मैथमेटिक्स के लिए इनके लिए हम लवेबल कैसे बना सकते हैं. व्हाट डू वी नीड टू डू टू मेक द फिजिक्स एंड मैथमेटिक्स लवेबल अमंग आवर किड्स. कैसे बना सकते हैं इसको एक इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक सब्जेक्ट, कैसे बना सकते हैं, चाहे आप एज अ जर्नल ले लें साइंस एंड साइंस, डोंट बी कन्फाइंड विद फिजिक्स एंड मैथमेटिक्स. ठीक है, हम इन मोस्ट ऑफ द आप ही कह रहे थे कि मैथमेटिक्स ज़्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट है, तो हम इसको इंटरेस्टिंग कैसे बना सकते हैं, कौन से स्टेप्स है जो हम ले सकते हैं इसको इंटरेस्ट बनाने का.
आई गेस टू द बेस्ट ऑफ माय अंडरस्टैंडिंग आई फील वी नीड टू वन देयर आर वेरियस फेजेस टू इट. One would be at the level of a teacher, second would be at the level of a parents, third would be at the level of the government as well for the policy making. At the level of, since we are teachers, put the teacher's perspective up there. Suppose, see, students have educate students regarding the career options in science or the basic sciences to be precise. Second, we need to just clear the image of a scientist in front of a student. Students have just the image of a scientist wearing a white coat with glasses in a lab. A scientist could be much more than that. A student would seem to be excited among some excited jobs, but the scientist job or a scientist scientific profession seems to be boring to most of the students to opt as the career option. So we need to clear that image. That's one. Second, as far as this part of the world in our Kashmir, I would suggest to see the practical component of the science cannot be underrated. It needs to be given much more importance than what it is being given now. Suppose for the sake of argument, if I give the example of the class 10, you have there, suppose if a student has 500 marks in total, because evaluation is a necessary part of the curriculum. If we have 500 marks in class 10 for the students as a whole, only, I guess to the best of my knowledge, only 16 marks out of 500 are allotted to the practical aspect, and which is too low. So students would concentrate on 484 marks apart from being involved in the 16 marks as well. So it needs to be done on the evaluation part as well. We need to give more weightage to the experimental part of the science as well. And that need, and from the teacher's responsibility, that practical component doesn't need to be just mere formality. So, and apart from that, as far as the government, no doubt, recently has taken few initiatives to develop the insight for the science or the scientific temperament of the students. The Department of Science and Technology has recently, launched a scheme, Inspire scheme, for the students of class 11 and 12, where they, in every state or in every area, they have designated a university of or other some national institute for that purpose, where they just get this bright students from every school and just to train them or just to give them a training for 4 or 5 days. It's a residential training, in our Kashmir, as well as University of Kashmir and the National Institute of Technology has been organizing these Inspire camps. So the Department of Science and Technology has, it's better late than never, has taken up the initiative of developing the scientific temperament among the students. And apart from that, I guess the people who are involved in the science, the scientists need to be given more social recognition from the societal point of view, as well as from the government point of view, so that the students may make these scientists as role model. Now, currently, every kid, he would have a football player or a cricket player as his role model. But I guess hardly there would be anyone who would be having some scientist as their role model. So these Inspire programs launched by the Department of Science and Technology has been a step towards that. The obviously, we have organized a few also. While being part of the NIT. So we invite various scientific minds of the country and abroad from abroad also, they come here and they deliver talks and try to motivate students regarding science. It's a residential program for 5 days. Students stay there in the hostel for the night as well. And for full 5 days, they try to motivate the students towards the basic science. So, and let me bring it to your notes as well here, that it's not a problem at the regional level that there's a decline in the students opting towards science. It has been seen as an overall trend in India as well, and even globally. So the government of India has waken up to the initiative that more and more students need to be, motivated towards taking basic science as their career option.
डॉक्टर साहब, मेरा अगला सवाल होगा कि सही बात है आपने कही कि ये ग्लोबल ट्रेंड है. मैंने भी पिछली बार एक आर्टिकल में पढ़ा था कि ऑनली शायद 11.6% पीपल आर नो टू मैथमेटिक्स, बाकी लोग तो बहुत पीछे हट रहे हैं इससे, और बच्चों में बड़ा फोबिया पाया जाता है. तो हमारा यही मकसद है कि हम बच्चों के साथ बात करें, इस बारे में जानने कि क्या फोबिया है, क्या रीज़न हो सकता है कि मैथमेटिक्स इतनी दूरी बढ़ती जा रही है, चाहे ये ग्लोबल ट्रेंड है या चाहे एक रीजनल ट्रेंड है. तो लेकिन हमें तो अपने रीजन के हिसाब से सोचना है कि हम यहाँ पे क्या कर सकते हैं और हमारी कोशिश क्या रहेगी कि हम इस चीज़ को चेंज कर सकते हैं. तो मेरा अगला क्वेश्चन है कि आप मुझे बताएं कि हाउ कैन मेक दिस फिजिक्स एंड मैथमेटिक्स कैसे डिफरेंट कैन मेक योर लाइफ कैन मेक अ डिफरेंस इन आवर लाइव्स.
I guess our society, all the sciences with due regards to other scientific branch, science branch as well. See, you cannot relate to your society without physics or mathematics. Well, for the sake of forget about the mathematics in the higher standards, even in a societal level, what you exactly termed out societal level. See, man is a social animal. So once we are social animals, we are related to other people as well. There's a give and take process. There is the transportation is involved, the communication is involved. So every societal component, since man being a social animal, so the mathematics gets involved even to those persons who are illiterate. Because had we not been social animal, so the societal implication of mathematics might have been less. But being a social animal, the importance of the mathematics becomes much more. Because you need to get involved with other people as well. Once you get involved with other people as well, as I mentioned, there will be give and take process involving mathematics. There will be communication which involves mathematics. There will be transportation and all that stuff which involves mathematics. So everything is numbers. Even you cannot distinguish. Separate mathematics from the society. And similarly, I'm just talking about the societal implication of the mathematics, or for that sake, physics. You can similarly, physics is a very essential component for the society and for other branches as well. You cannot think about the engineering or the technology without physics. We cannot think about even the computer technology without the physics. You just see about the society. And I'm exactly talking about your question, trying to reply that the societal implications. You cannot imagine the medical sciences without the physics. You cannot, imagine the magnetic MRI, the magnetic resonance imaging. You cannot, imagine the ultrasonography. The societal implication without the physics. So all of these, the mathematics and physics, they're just intermingled in the society. That is, even whatever we think of, it just involved or bound up with the mathematics and the physics in general. So the temperament among the students needs to be ignited.
ठीक है डॉक्टर साहब। डॉक्टर साहब एक क्वेश्चन है कि हायर एजुकेशन के रिलेटेड, क्योंकि 30-40 साल से कश्मीर यूनिवर्सिटी मास्टर्स करवा रही है और आज भी करवा रही है, उसके बाद रिसर्च का भी ट्रम चलता रहता है, तो एक रूटीन सी रहती है मास्टर्स में कि आप सेमेस्टर में जाते हो, सेकंड सेमेस्टर में जाते हो, आपका क्वेश्चन आंसर सिस्टम रहता है, फिर एग्जामिनेशन सब्जेक्टिव हो या ऑब्जेक्टिव हो, तो ट्रम चलती रहती है। तो क्या आपने इस बार कुछ बींग एन कोऑर्डिनेटर ऑफ द डिपार्टमेंट, क्या आपने कुछ नया ट्रेंड देखा है जहाँ से हम ज्यादा इनकल्केट कर सकते हैं फिजिक्स या बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट्स को बच्चों में एक इंटरेस्ट डेवलप करने के लिए? तो क्या आपने कुछ हटके ट्रेंड इस बार सोचा है इस बारे में फिजिक्स के बारे में?
See, finally, by the end of the day, your mind may have certain, ways and means of evaluating the students. But finally, we're talking about a formal education system. I mean, a university education system is a formal education system. So you need to follow certain protocols set up by the policymakers like the UGC, University Grants Commission, for that sake. I mean, you cannot just have any random state of the evaluation. I mean, there has to be, I suppose, currently we are, apart from this lockdown, we are, involved with the pen and paper basis of the evaluation, where we ask questions, you expect student to write answers. I mean, this is the type of the examination system which is going around in the country. I mean, you cannot change them. I mean, as a teacher, you cannot change them. It's a policy decision. It's education.
I would like to interrupt here. Actually, जो मेरा क्वेश्चन था वो ये है कि जो मास्टर्स करके निकल जाते हैं बाद में वही बच्चे रिसर्च के लिए चले जाते हैं, या वही बाद में हमारी इस डोमेन में एज ए टीचर बन के आते हैं या लेक्चरर बन के आते हैं, तो जो जिस लेवल की फिजिक्स उनकी उनके अंदर वहाँ चली जाती है, जिस लेवल की फिजिक्स वो सीख पाते हैं, उसी लेवल की फिजिक्स बाद में वो डिलीवर करेंगे। तो मैं फिजिक्स को लेकर नहीं कह रहा हूँ, मैथ्स और फिजिक्स दोनों को लेकर कह रहा हूँ, जनरल मैं कह रहा हूँ। तो क्या मैं उस मेरा क्वेश्चन जो है कि क्या उस लेवल पे आप कुछ कर रहे हैं कि ज्यादा से ज्यादा इन्वॉल्वमेंट हो जाए, मेरा ये मतलब है कि ज्यादा से ज्यादा हमारे पास एक आसानी आ जाए।
What we try to do is there's small changes we are trying to get up in the system. The first, we are trying to involve students for the project work at the bachelor's level as well, which has not been a trend earlier.
Exactly.
Yeah, we are trying to involve the students in the bachelor's level as well for the project work. One. Second, for the master's level, we are trying to, for no, earlier the project for the master's level used to be for one semester. What we are trying to do is, since in 6 months time the students are not able to complete their projects, we are trying to stretch the project for 1 year for the master's level, which it would at least would give some breathing time to the students to complete their projects, because in semester break they can go to outside to carry some experimentation as well. So this is the second change we are trying to incorporate. And the third, at the master's level, we are trying to give them more options of choosing their choice of the subjects between, suppose somebody might be interested in the relativity, somebody might be interested in the material science or the solid state physics or the nuclear physics. So we're trying to give them more choice. Plus, apart from that, we are trying to get, obviously our university, we cannot hide, shy out by speaking of the fact that our university is still in infancy, but still we're trying to get more experiments so that the students would at least get insight about these as well, because these are the minor modifications we're trying to do with the curriculum.
जी डॉक्टर साहब, यही मेरा मतलब था कि हम तो उस जो रूल होगा, कैरिकुलम होगा, हम उसको चेंज नहीं कर सकते हैं, जो एक नेशनल लेवल पे प्रोटोकॉल होगा हम उसको कैसे बता सकते हैं। तो एक और क्वेश्चन सर कि हम ब्रिजिंग कैसे कर सकते हैं, जब हम हायर क्लास में जाते हैं तो एक लेवल की फिजिक्स रहती है जिसमें हाई कॉन्सेप्ट रहते हैं मैथमेटिक्स के, और इसी तरह से जो हमारे लो लेवल रहती है 11th-10th के बच्चे होते हैं, उसके बाद 12th के बच्चे होते हैं, तो हम उस चीज को कैसे ब्रिजिंग करेंगे, एक लेवल उनमें हम डेवलप करेंगे कि लेवल के हिसाब से हम उसके उनके बेस को क्लियर कर सकते हैं, तो उसका आप हमें कुछ पॉइंट्स बता दें, उसका हम कैसे कर सकते हैं कि एक लेवल के साथ साथ हम उनमें स्टैंडर्ड भी डेवलप कर सकते हैं।
I guess see, you correctly pointed out there ki hum ek the normal procedure, I guess I had been of victim of such things as well, where a teacher, he just tries to oversimplify the things, and while oversimplify this, oversimplifying the things. I mean, we give the wrong concept to the students. For the sake of argument, I guess you can hear me?
Yeah. You carry on, please.
Okay. I guess I'll just quote in one example. Once we had been told by one of our teachers, if we talk about, suppose, let's talk about the spin of electron. So spin of, while if you we want to teach the same concept to the students of class 11 and 12, what we try to do is we try to make them understand the easiest possible way. And but finally, as Einstein rightly pointed out, you should make things simple, not simpler. So you have to make them simple as long as their science doesn't go wrong. So we should not try to make it simpler. So just while, taking the level down to the level of the students, we make things wrong at times. Just suppose once we're told by someone that a spin, if we have an electron spin plus half and minus half, what do we mean by it? So we're obviously as students, everyone would ask a question. So a teacher, just to oversimplify the things, he says, if you have an op spinner, his spin is like a ball like this, it's a spin up, and while a leg spinner spin is like this, it's a down. So we just get excited, okay, we have understood the spin. But this is entirely nonsense. This is not the spin, how it goes. So spin is simply a quantum number. It just comes up from some calculations. So that's just because it doesn't have a classical analog. So we just can't make the students understand spin. So your point is right, how to bridge it. But there are certain things where if you try to oversimplify it, they would go wrong. So you just have to be there, right? You just have to maintain the fine line between making things simple and making things incorrect. So it's better to be untaught than to be ill-taught. So my suggestion would be that things should be made only simple and not simpler, as Einstein rightly pointed out. Otherwise, because there are certain things, the problem is, there are certain things which don't have a classical analog, which are purely quantum mechanical in nature, and you cannot simplify them. I mean, you will get confused while trying to understand that. But it doesn't mean, in order to remove that confusion, you'll just make incorrect statements about that in order for your student to understand. I mean, you just have to maintain a scientific base. I mean, it's there. The student has to get up to the base. It doesn't mean that you will go for the incorrect or infactual statements in order to reach down to the level of the students, because for the time being that may be helpful. Our students may understand that I have understood the quantum mechanics, I have understood the school for that sake, the Heisenberg's uncertainty principle, or the for the electron spin for that purpose. But after some time, he would realize that whatever I had learned, it is incorrect.
Yeah, absolutely. Thank you very much, Dr. Saab. Kafi istifada le lenge hum aapki in baaton se. और बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया कि आपने अपना कीमती वक्त निकाला और हमें सुनने का मौका दिया. इंशाल्लाह अगली बार भी आपकी जरूरत पड़ेगी. थैंक यू वेरी मच डॉक्टर साहब.
थैंक यू.